These three problems here may seem quite complicated, and as you can see on the right, they require integration using trigonometric substitutions to obtain the solutions. Through this video, you will learn the patterns in the rules of trigonometric substitution. Additionally, we'll explore how to solve this problem without even needing trigonometric substitution, and even calculate the answer mentally. Now, let's dive into the rules of trigonometric substitution. If you have square root of a squared minus x squared, you can substitute x with a times sine theta. If the order is reversed with x squared minus a squared, you can substitute x with a times secant theta. Finally, if you have square root of a squared plus x squared, you can substitute x with a times tangent theta. These rules may seem complex at first glance, but all you need to remember is that for trigonometric substitution in integrals, you'll be using sine theta, secant theta, or tangent theta, depending on the situation. Let's explore in more detail. If there's a minus sign between a constant squared and x squared inside the square root, you can choose either sine theta or secant theta for substitution. So when do we use sine theta and when do we use secant theta? When the constant squared appears in front, we can substitute x with sine theta. However, there's no need to memorize this rule specifically. Just remember the fact that when there's a minus sign, you can choose between sine theta or secant theta for substitution. If we substitute x with a times sine theta in the square root of a squared minus x squared, it becomes the square root of a squared minus a squared times sine squared theta. By factorizing out a squared, we get a squared times 1 minus sine squared theta. Now, using one of the trigonometric identities, sine squared theta plus cosine squared theta equals 1, we can simplify 1 minus sine squared theta to cosine squared theta. Substituting this value back into the square root, we can express it as a times cosine theta without the square root. What would happen if we substituted x with a secant theta? Let's take a look together. The square root of a squared minus x squared would become the square root of a squared minus a squared times secant squared theta. And if we factor out a squared, the term inside the square root can be expressed as a squared times 1 minus secant squared theta. Now, let's use one of the trigonometric identities, 1 plus tangent squared theta equals secant squared theta. If we rearrange the terms, 1 minus secant squared theta becomes negative tangent squared theta. And when we substitute this term into the square root, it becomes negative a squared times tangent squared theta, which means the value inside the square root becomes negative, and thus not possible. Similarly, for the expression square root of x squared minus a squared, since there is a minus sign inside the root, we need to substitute x with either sine theta or secant theta. If we substitute x with a secant theta, the square root of x squared minus a squared becomes the square root of a squared times secant squared theta minus a squared. And when we factor out a squared, the term inside the root becomes a squared times secant squared theta minus 1. Using the trigonometric identity we used before, 1 plus tangent squared theta equals secant squared theta, we can simplify secant squared theta minus 1 to tangent squared theta. And when we substitute it back into the root, we get the square root of a squared tangent squared theta, which simplifies to a times tangent theta and eliminates the root. What if we substitute x with a sine theta by mistake? We can quickly realize that something is wrong. The term inside the square root becomes a squared sine squared theta minus a squared, which can be simplified to a squared sine squared theta minus 1. Since sine squared theta plus cosine theta equals 1, sine squared theta minus 1 becomes negative cosine squared theta. Therefore, when you substitute this expression into the root, we end up with a negative value, which is not possible. While it would be ideal to memorize the exact substitutions for each case, at least remembering that sine theta or secant theta should be used when there's a minus sign inside the square root can greatly help in problem solving. Now, let's explore when we substitute tangent theta. If there's a plus sign between the square of a constant and x squared, we need to substitute x with a tangent theta. Notice how the left plus sign resembles the t in tangent theta? You can remember it that way if it helps. Now, let's see how we simplify the expression a squared plus x squared inside the square root. Upon substitution, it becomes a squared plus a squared tangent squared theta, and further simplifying gives us a squared 1 plus tangent squared theta. Since 1 plus tangent squared theta is equal to secant squared theta, the square root of a squared secant squared theta simplifies to a times secant theta. It is a very straightforward simplification, so please remember that we use a times sine theta, a secant theta, and a tangent theta for the respective cases.
If you've been enjoying this video so far,
why not hit that subscribe button
and smash that like button?
Your support means a lot to me. Now, let's solve an example problem together. The first problem is the integral of 1 over x squared times square root of 9 minus x squared. We see the square root of 9 minus x squared in the denominator. Let's substitute x with 3 sine theta. Then it becomes the square root of 9 minus 9 squared theta, which can be simplified as the square root of 9 times 1 minus sine squared theta, and further simplified as the square root of 9 times cosine squared theta. Therefore, it simplifies to 3 cosine theta. To substitute all the x variables with theta, we also need to replace dx with d theta, since dx over d theta is equal to 3 cosine theta. Hence, dx becomes 3 cosine theta d theta. Now, let's rewrite the problem and substitute all x variables with theta. The denominator inside the integral becomes 3 sine theta squared times 3 cosine theta, and dx becomes 3 cosine theta d theta. We can then cancel out the 3 cosine theta in both the numerator and denominator. So this integral can be simplified as 1 over 9 times the integral of 1 over sine squared theta d theta, which can be further written as 1 over 9 times the integral of cosecant squared theta d theta. The integral of cosecant squared theta is negative cotangent theta. So the answer is negative 1 over 9 times cotangent theta plus c. Is the calculation complete? Not yet. Our problem was originally expressed in terms of x, and we only temporarily substituted theta for x. Therefore, we need to rewrite the answer in terms of x again. Since we previously substituted x with just 3 sine theta becomes x over 3. Now, let's draw a right triangle and apply sine theta to it. The opposite side becomes x, and the hypotenuse is 3. Using the Pythagorean theorem, the adjacent side becomes the square root of 9 minus x squared. Now, we can easily find tangent theta as x over square root of 9 minus x squared, and its reciprocal cotangent theta becomes square root of 9 minus x squared over x. Therefore, the previously calculated answer of negative 1 over 9 cotangent theta plus c becomes negative 1 over 9 square root of 9 minus x squared over x plus c. Just like we did here, don't forget to convert the variable back to x in the final result. The second example is the integral of square root of x squared minus 3 over x. Since 3 inside the square root can be expressed as the square of square root 3, let's substitute x with square root 3 times secant theta. The numerator becomes square root 3 secant squared theta minus 3. After factoring, the expression inside the square root becomes 3 times secant squared theta minus 1. As we did before, we can rewrite secant squared theta minus 1 as tangent squared theta, so the expression simplifies to square root 3 times tangent theta without the square root. Now, let's express dx in terms of theta. Differentiating x equals square root 3 times secant theta with respect to theta, we get dx over d theta equals square root 3 secant theta tangent theta, so dx becomes square root 3 times secant theta times tangent theta and d theta. Now, the integral we'll see can be expressed as the integral of square root 3 tangent theta over square root 3 times secant theta times square root 3 times secant theta tangent theta and d theta. Canceling square root 3 times secant theta in the numerator and the denominator and bringing the constant outside the integral, we have a square root 3 integral of tangent square theta. Unfortunately, there's no direct way to integrate tangent squared theta, But we can use the identity 1 plus tangent squared theta equals secant squared theta to rewrite tangent squared theta as secant squared theta minus 1. Then the previous integral becomes square root 3 integral of secant squared theta minus 1, resulting in square root 3 tangent theta minus theta plus c. However, this is still in terms of theta and not the final answer. Since x was substituted as square root 3 secant theta, x over square root 3 becomes secant theta, and taking the reciprocal of both sides, cosine theta becomes square root 3 over x. Now, let's draw a right triangle and apply cosine theta to it. The adjacent side becomes square root 3, and the hypotenuse becomes x. So the opposite side is square root of x squared minus 3. By examining the triangle, we can find that tangent theta is square root x squared minus 3 over square root 3, and theta can be expressed as arccosine square root 3 over x. Therefore, the previously obtained expression of square root 3 times tangent theta minus theta plus c becomes square root 3 square root x squared minus 3 over square root 3 minus arccosine square root 3 over x plus c. Let's examine how trigonometric substitutions work in definite integrals. Since we have a square root of 1 plus x squared in the denominator, let's substitute x with tangent theta and simplify. As I mentioned before, when there is a minus sign inside the square root, we substitute with sine theta or secant theta. And when there's a plus sign, like in this case, we substitute with tangent theta. Now, square root 1 plus x squared becomes square root 1 plus tangent squared theta, which can be further expressed as square root secant squared theta. Hence, it simplifies to secant theta. Now let's express dx in terms of theta by differentiating both sides of x equals tangent theta with respect to theta. The derivative of tangent theta is secant squared theta, so dx becomes secant squared theta d theta. Let's rewrite the problem again. Personally, when dealing with definite integrals that require substitution, I prefer to express the integration limits using the variable. For example, I would write the integral from x equals 0 to x equals 1. This helps remind us to transform the integration limits using the substituted function. When x equals 0, tangent theta is also 0, so theta is 0. On the other hand, when x is 1, tangent theta becomes 1, so the theta is pi over 4. Now, let's substitute all the x values in the problem with theta. When theta varies from 0 to pi over 4, the integral of 1 over secant cubed theta times secant squared theta can be simplified to the integral of 1 over secant theta, which is equivalent to the integral of cosine theta. Hence, the integral becomes sine theta, and the integration range is from 0 to pi over 4. Therefore, the answer is sine pi over 4 minus sine 0, which equals square root 2 over 2. The last problem is the one that I mentioned in the beginning of the video. This problem also has the expression a squared minus x squared inside the square root. So it seems like we need to substitute it with 2 sine theta. However, there's a simpler way to solve it using a graphical approach. The function we need to integrate is y equals square root 4 minus x squared. And since the right side is a square root, y must be greater than or equals to 0. By squaring both sides, we get y squared is 4 minus x squared, and the rearranging the terms gives us x squared plus y squared equals 4, which is the equation of a circle. If we plot the graph, we see that it forms a circle with a radius of 2. The range we need to integrate is x from 0 to 2, and since y is greater than or equals to 0, we only need to consider the area in the first quadrant. This area occupies only a quarter of the entire circle, so the answer is pi r squared times quarter. Substituting the radius r with 2, we get pi times 2 squared times quarter, which is simplifies to pi. If we knew that this problem was about finding the area of circle from the beginning, we could have easily evaluated the integral without any substitution. If today's video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing and hitting the like button. It'll be a great encouragement for me. Thanks for watching, and I appreciate your support. I've been your math guardian, Alex.